To my parents, My father, Zichrona Livracha, had the Bore Lechaim Aruchi, my mother, whose straightness and tmimus are for me a basis for life. Ulam Ha'alfai, Moirim, my Rebbeim, some of them who are not with us anymore, whose clarity and tahara in the Masorah of Torah, Yerushalayim, and Pesach Halacha will always enlighten my ways for Ezra Hashem Yitbarach. My thoughts go also to my previous Kehillah Kedosha of Luzern in Switzerland, which I was zocheh to serve. And now, with sincere thanks to this outstanding and famous Kaladas Yeshua, which under the leadership of Kohen Moreh Diaspora Gemeshliter has granted me the honor to stand amidst you today. May HaKadosh Baruch Hu Berachem Avarubim fulfill the words of yesterday's parsha, Hashkifo Mimayin Kotshecho Min HaShomayim Ugoreich Es Am Kohes Yisrael. Look down from your holy residence from heaven and send your bracha to your nation, to Israel. In this pasuk of Hashkifu Mimayin Kotshecho Min HaShomayim, which marks the end of the parsha of Vidui Master, the Torah uses the expression of Hashkifo, which we find in another place in a completely different context. Vayukumu mishomu anoshim, vayashkifu al pnei sedoim, and the Malachim got up from there and looked down to sedoim. And Rashi quotes Divrei Chazal, saying, כל השקופו שבמיקרו לרו, חוץ מהשקיף וממי קודשכו מן השמיים, שגודל כויח מתנס עניים שהופך מן הזרגז לרחם. Meaning, every expression of the word השקיפו, which we find in Psukim, has an orientation to the negative. With the exception of השקיפו ממי קודשכו מן השמיים, which is said in the context of giving Trumas Omaisis, because the strength of Matnas Aniyim is so tremendous big that it transforms the middah of severity and strictness, the middah Hadin, to the middah of pity and compassion, to the middah Zerachim. I never understood this Chazal. What is this middah Hadin, this middah of severity, which has to be overturned here? What could be the reason of the Midas Hadin here? A man who possesses a piece of land, and the land produces fruits, and after the harvest, the owner took off Trumas Umaisis. Where should be there any room for Midas Hadin? Rabboisai, I think there is a significant chiddush here, and a tremendous and important message. Everything one gets, everything in life that makes a person to be a Makar, being the one who takes, is accompanied with Midas Hadin, goes together with a claim of Din V'cheshbon. What will you do with this present? What purpose will you use it for? To take and to accept is Mo'eva Midas Hadin. Possessing a field, having Atzloch in the harvest, that is not obvious. These are presents min ha-shamayim. No, as you got these presents and you use them to sustain koyanim leviim and all other aniyim, so you took to be able to give, you transformed the kabbalah into an asina. In that case, the midas hadin which arose by receiving is transformed into midas racham. It's godel koyach matnas aniyim, giving away שהויפך מידס רויגס ורחמי, transforms the מידס הדין to מידס הדין. I think that is not only true concerning earthly goods, parnosah, gashmias, but also refers to spiritual goods. Limboit ulelamit, to learn and to teach, are not only two different levels. Lelamit is in truth a legalization of limit, because Torah is not private ownership, Torah belongs to Klal Yisrael. and has to be used whenever possible for the strengthening of Avodas Hashem. I think that that is the explanation of the tefillah we say on Shabbos. Yismach Moshe, Matnas Kelka. Moshe Rabbeinu can rejoice at the matona he got to be in his share. To rejoice at the matona, how can I be glad with receiving? That is only possible ki evet nemon kavosar. Because you called him a loyal servant. Noikein avdi Moshe, b'chol beisi nemon. A loyal servant uses all his capabilities and all his belongings to serve his master. When that is so, Yismach Moshe. He can really rejoice with the gift he got. Evet Nemon is not just a giving away of some goods. It is giving away oneself entirely for the Rabbeinu Shel Olam's concerns. And Sibur of men and women who live such a life are indeed entitled to benefit of the bracha of Hashkifu Mimayin Kotshakor. Perhaps these words will help us to understand the essence of the mitzvah of Avorat Bikurim we read in yesterday's parsha. The owner of a piece of land in Eretz Yisrael brings to the Kohen in Beis HaMikdash the best of the best, Shivas Haminim and Min HaMufcher Mishivas Haminim. And he is not alone. All the others who have to bring Bikurim join him. Like Chazal say in the Mishnah, and they go up all together to Yerushalayim, singing Shomaso Machti Ba'oyim Le'Beis Hashem Le'elik, singing Oyim Dosoy Ragleini B'Shurayim Yerushalayim, till they arrive in the Azor, and they put their Bikurim down next to the Mizbeach, and read the Parsha of Bikurim. One can imagine what a tremendous Isharus this person had experienced. Beginning in his field, next to his tree, and ending lifnei Hashem, v'nachter lifnei Hashem alekech. Ich gewalti. And after all this, v'shtachavizo lifnei Hashem. The purpose of all this was to bring a person to the stage of bending down, of recognizing his bittul standing lifnei Hashem, of realizing that all he got and all his achievements are only a way leading to be a servant. And all this vast endeavor of Avodas Bikurim was only for the purpose of the Hishtachaviso. And then, after the Hishtachaviso, then comes at the very end, Shesomachto l'chol ha'toyim, Asherosan Hashem elekecho b'Yisrael. Now you can rejoice with all the good which Hashem has given you and to your family. Now all your God will be accompanied with pure and real sinful. Yismach, the matnas chelkoi, he evet nemon korosom. Today, we don't have bikurim, the eino liyotcholim la'avoy yisrul ishtach avos. What can bring us to lead a lifestyle of being evdei Hashem? To be aware of the necessity of bending down and to be dedicated to Avodas Hashem. There is a gewaltig medrash tanchuma in the beginning of the parsha. Ze she'omer ha'kosov, boyu nishtachaven michro'o v'nivracho lifnei Hashem Eiseinu. Come, let us prostrate, kneel and bend down before Hashem our Maker. Three different expressions of ishtachavoy. Sofo Moshe shebeis hamikdash osum lichorev ubikurim asidim liposim. Moshe Rabbeinu foresaw that the beis hamikdash will be destroyed and bikurim will stop. Chazal say a chiddush. Omad vehiskin shemispalim shorosh pomim b'yoyim. So Moshe Rabbeinu was mesaker that one should be mispalim three times a day. Shechavivot tfilo lifnei HaKadosh Baruch Hu yoisim mikol ma'asev toivim. Because tfilo is cherished before the Rebbeinu Shel Olam more than all the ma'asev toivim. Three terms of ishtach avoya for three tfilos of the day. instead of one ishtachavoya, which resulted out of one avoas bikurim once a year, we need today three daily tefillas, because so remote could be without Beis HaMikdash the idea to give away ourselves and our belongings to Avodas Hashem. So difficult is it to bend down. And just as Bikurim took place to Rav Om, so too is the call of Moshe Rabbeinu to Rav Om, to the cloud. Boyu, Loshen Rabbein, Nishtarabe, Nichro'o, V'nivrecho lifnei Hashem Oseinu. We all together, let's go down. Let's find the ability to dedicate our life to Kiddush Shem Shomayim. Let's be mischazik b'tfilo, to shape a cloud of Oivdei Hashem. Let's strengthen together ourselves to go on developing a cloud of Loimdei Soiro, medagdekei b'mitzvos, and going in the footsteps of Avoseinu v'Avoseinu. Let's strengthen together to shape, to go on with shaping a tzibur whose chinuch, kashrus, and sakaloche stand in the highest level of Kiddush Shem Shomayim. And b'siyata d'shmaya, we will be zoche to hatzloche, and be zoche to be mekadosh Shem Shomayim, and all of us will be zoche to aksiva v'chasiva toivah. Let me just end with the tefillah of Chazal, for one who enters the Beis HaMikdash. What's a mitzvah? Hashem Elokai, shelo yera avarta kol al yodi, la'omer al tometoi, al tometoi, le'koshel bidvar alochem, yismuchu b'chadera, le'koshel chadera bidvar alochem, esma kohem. Gal einai v'abito nifloiz mitevosecho, ומשהו שגיסי כבר, עמידה לי עלו אמס. ועל תצל מפי דבר אמס עד מאוית, כי השם ייתן חוכמו מפי דעס וסמונה.